Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's game between the Piedmont International University Bruins and the Columbia International University Rams out of Columbia, South Carolina. And we'll have the starting lineups and the national anthem, and then we'll get right back to you.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as we set to begin, the starters for Columbia International University are number 3, J.C. Cabin, number 13, Gordy Frierson, 32, Devin Williams, 34, Kevin Evans, and number 44, Ryan Faber. And for Piedmont, on the floor tonight, we've got Javon Summers, number 1, point guard out of Winston-Salem, number 4, Malik Milton. Number 12, Tim Worlds. He's out of Radford. Mike Key out of Moxville, right up the street. 44, Nate Hewitt. He's from Fayetteville. Referees tonight, head referee Jeff Dre. You have Randy Doolin and Robbie Lester. And the game gets underway. And Columbia gets the tip. Piedmont starting out in a man-to-man defense with pressure, and Javon Summers is all over J.C. Cabin and about stole it from him. Ball out of bounds. It'll go out to Columbia. Tuesday night, January the 13th, downtown Winston-Salem. Crowds down a little bit tonight. It's an earlier game. Threat of inclement weather in the forecast. We've got a discussion going on at the scoreboard. Robbie Lester gets it figured out. And we're back underway. Cabin with the basketball. Head basketball coach for Columbia is Kyle Mendenhall. And their assistant coach is Danny Reese. And for Piedmont, head coach Clint Walker and assistant coach Bob Mabe. Walker been with Piedmont. This is his fourth year, I believe. Mendenhall, this is just his second year at Columbia. And it's Columbia's only their second year of basketball. Their program has just gotten started. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later on in the game. Piedmont inbounds the basketball under their goal. Spoke with Coach Walker this afternoon before the game. And one of his concerns were in the tournament this last weekend, they were out-rebounded by almost 15 rebounds a game. Speaking of rebound, big Nate Hewitt takes a miss by Milton and puts it back up in and scores. It's 2-0. Kentucky Christian and Pensacola both had more than 40 rebounds against Piedmont. And Coach Walker said that most of practice all day yesterday, that was what the focus was on, was rebounding. ...18-28, remaining 4-2 is the score. Piedmont with a lead. Javon Summers slowly brings the ball up the court. Let's see if Piedmont works patiently on their offense. Earlier this year, they have gotten out of sorts somewhat with their offense, going down quickly, shooting shots, and not being patient, not running their offense the way they want to. And Piedmont has a young team. And a lot of times with a young team, you're going to get that. But later on in the season, with some games under their belt, you're hoping they'll learn from experience. Milton tried to get it inside to Hewitt. Looks like there's a little miscommunication. And there's a turnover for Piedmont. Kevin Evans with a nice little pass into Ryan Faber, and the score is tied, 4-4. Mike Key with the ball, left side. Hewitt comes up to set a pick. Key drives the lane, puts up a little shot and misses it. Evans comes down. The pass to Faber. He misses it. Piedmont with the rebound. Milton with it now. Right side. And they set the ball up for offense. Kean Summers at the top, running the offense. Key with a nice little pass over to Milton in the corner, and he drains it. Good execution on offense by Piedmont that time. Working for the shot they wanted. They got Milton open in the corner, and he drained it. 7-4, Piedmont by 3. There's a shot blocked by Summers. Key gets it. Piedmont up the court. Key with a little spin move in the middle. And he drops it. When Key gets an open court like that, and you give him that much lane, he's going to be hard to stop. Mike Key in his senior year at Piedmont did not play the first semester. Nice pass by Javon Summers on the inlet to Hewitt, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. But Mike Key came back for the tournament and for this second semester. He won the most valuable player of the tournament. And in the 3 games he played, he averaged a little over 27 points a game. And the addition of Key into this lineup, into this offense, really gives Piedmont a chance down the stretch to compete for a district championship. I talked with Coach Walker before the game, and he said that that one of the issues they may have early is finding the right chemistry once you bring a player like that and inserting back into the lineup. But knowing these players and knowing the coaching staff, they'll have this team clicking very soon. Kevin Evans drives the lane. Columbia scores 9-6. Stuart Taylor into the game now for Piedmont. Roba Flint, Justin Valentine, and C.J. Tyson. Tyson dribbles around a little bit, pulls up, knocks it down. Little baseline jumper. And Tyson, when he gets on, he really can shoot. Marcus Prelo into the game now for Columbia, and he drives the lane, and Nate Hewitt shifted just a little bit slow, and they call the blocking foul on him. And that'll bring in number 23, Tanner Poole, for Hewitt. 15-11 remaining. Piedmont up by 5. Columbia inbounding the ball underneath their basket. Ball knocked out of bounds. Columbia having a little trouble getting it in bounds. Piedmont drops into a zone now. And Marcus Prelo knocks down the little jumper from about 15 on the baseline. Stuart Taylor running the court. Running the point guard, slowly brings the ball up court, right side to Roba Flint. Tyson pulls up from about 23, and he can hit that. But this one didn't fall. Columbia now with a basketball. Piedmont up by 3. Columbia working it around. There's the miss. Stuart Taylor comes in with a rebound. Quickly gets the ball up court. Let's see if Piedmont can work the offense. Tyson with the basketball. Tries to dribble it inside, loses it out to Taylor. Taylor misses it. It looks like Tyson and J.C. Cabin got their arms tangled up on the rebound, and wasn't much Tyson could do about it once his arm was in there. And there's the foul called on him. Piedmont showing a little bit of half-court trap, looks like. Showing some pressure. Ball bounces around. And finally, Stuart Taylor comes off the rebound. There's about four or five opportunities. Columbia just came down with a rebound. Piedmont couldn't get it. Tyson with a rebound on the offense. It's one of the things Coach Walker was talking about before the game, was learning how to box out, learning how to rebound, especially on offense. Or keeping the other team's offense from rebounding offensively is what Walker was talking about. And Piedmont struggling a little bit. Columbia being patient with their offense, trying to work it around. Piedmont back at a man. Roba Flynn all over the top. Tanner Poole tries to come down with some pressure, and it's stolen by Justin Valentine, and a beautiful pass up the court to Stuart Taylor, and he scores. Blocked by Taylor. Columbia with a basketball still. 12:05 remaining to go in the first half. A new set of five ready to check in for Piedmont. They're cheering on the team that's on the floor right now. 10 on the shot clock. In the corner. And Naquan Wilson had a beautiful little runner, and he missed it. And once again, Piedmont got out-rebounded. Number 32, Kevin Evans, snuck in there and got the rebound. And put it back up. But there was a turnover, and Piedmont will have the basketball. So we've got Justin Summers back on the point. Mike Key back in the game. Tim Wurls, Malik Milton, and there's a pass from Summers to Milton. They'll run that play about three times a game. Milton with the ability to get up there and put the ball in the basket. Ball out of bounds to Columbia. 15-8, Piedmont with a lead. Number one, Daniel Collins, checks into the game for Columbia. Collins, just a freshman. As I talked with Coach Mendenhall earlier today, he said Collins is a player that if he can consistently be on, he could be a great player. And as we're speaking about him, he knocks down a three. Summers try to inlet pass to Milton. And it got knocked away. And Daniel Collins comes in right off the bench. And within about 15 seconds has put in 5 points. 15-13. Piedmont trying to show some patience on offense. Sometimes I think kids, when you talk about patience, they want you to, you think they're going to, they think they should play slower, it seems like to me. And it seems like Piedmont is just moving the ball slow. They're trying to be patient, but they're not playing their game. They're not moving the ball crisp and being patient. We're moving the ball slow. Key with the basketball now. Kicks it out to Wurls, down to Milton. Milton misses it. Hewitt fighting for the rebound, can't get it. and the game's tied at 15. Daniel Collins puts up a three and misses. He was wide open. Milton down with the basketball. He pulls up, kicks it out to Wurls, who's open from the corner. He missed the whole thing. Wurls can usually knock down that shot, but every once in a while, he'll miss one like that. Columbia moving the ball around. Daniel Collins pulls up for another three. That kid's not afraid to shoot. Here comes Summers. Puts it up. No good. Mike Key, the rebound, puts it up and in. 17-15. Piedmont with a lead. And Daniel Collins takes it to the hole and scores. Ball game tied at 17. Piedmont being patient. Milton pulls up from three. And Milton has yet to learn to follow a shot. Several shots he's pulled up and let it go. If he'd have followed it, he'd probably gotten his rebound. Hewitt was wide open in the lane. Key got it to him, and there's a whistle called, or a whistle blown. It'll be Piedmont's basketball. Entering the game for Piedmont, C.J. Tyson, and Tony Sue in the game for the first time. Trouble with the mic here. All right, now we've got it back. 7:34 remaining. Columbia will go to the foul line. That'll be number 42, Hudson Taylor. And once again, Piedmont loses the battle of the boards. He knocks down the first one. Enter the game for Columbia International is Kelso Wright, 5'10 freshman. And the second one's good, and that'll bring Columbia within 1 point, 20-19. Columbia International is a lot like Piedmont. They have a lot of freshmen on their team. When I was talking with Coach Mendenhall earlier today, their leading scorer had an ankle injury, and so he's out. And sometimes eligibility requirements and that type of thing will keep a player out as well. And I think Coach Mendenhall said he had a couple players out with that. There's a nice little pass inside. Columbia scores, 21-20. They have a lead. Mike Key bringing down the basketball. Key left side to Milton. He pulls up. Nice shot. Piedmont yet to get their offense in rhythm. They've got the athletes and they've got the ability for their starting five at least to score 20 to 25 points a game each. Piedmont playing good defense. 10 on the shot clock. 6:14 remaining. Kelso Wright. Left side. to Collins, who misses it and whirls with a nice block out and a rebound. He kicks it back out to Key. Key will take it from the top. Walker calls out instructions from the bench. Malik Milton at the top. Takes it all the way in. Kicks it out to Tyson. And Tyson took steps with it, according to referee Randy Doolin. Checking in the game for Piedmont, number 23, Tanner Poole. There's a turnover. Tyson with it to Poole. Back to Tyson. Nice pass back from Poole. And Tyson's a recipient of it, and he scores. And there was a good transition basket by the Bruins. There's a timeout on the floor. Columbia International University, their record is 1-15 on the year. And being only their second season of basketball is not necessarily a bad record. You're trying to build a team, trying to build a program. And when I talked to Coach Mendenhall today, he said that's what they're doing. He's trying to tell the kids it's a process. You're not going to come out there and win a conference championship in 1 or 2 years. You've got to build and you've got to work together. And even with a record of 1-15, Columbia has been in the game with a lot of teams that just couldn't quite pull it out. Coach said they, well, once they have some experience, they'll learn how to win and they'll learn how to take those games that go to the wire and be able to pull some of them out. And Kevin Evans knocks down a three from the corner and the game's tied. Tim Wirls with the basketball, heading the point now. Let's see what Piedmont's got going here on offense. Columbia International in man-to-man. Malik Milton at the top. There's a pick from Poole. He pulls up from three. And he misses it. Columbia with the ball. Kevin Evans with a miss from the corner. Here's Key in the wide open court, and he scores. And Jeff Drake calls a charge on him, and Tim Wirls is on the court. He's down. He looks like he's hurt. Tim in obvious pain. The junior out of Radford, Virginia. Has been an integral part of this team for 3 years now. And we really hope Tim's okay. Tim's not only a good player on the court, this is a good kid off the court. Engaged to be married. To his high school sweetheart. Tim's one of those kids you love to have on the court during a game, but you love to have him on the court during practice as well. He works hard. He shows good leadership. And he has a great attitude. A Let's just hope Tim's okay. Game's tied at 24. They're going to carry him off. I'm not sure if it's his knee or his ankle. There's some times where in the past I've seen ankle injuries that you thought somebody may never walk again. And within 15 minutes they were good after they walked it off. And then I've seen some ankle injuries that you thought was nothing. The kid ended up breaking it. 4:18 remaining. Columbia with a basketball. They're bringing it down. Number three, J.C. Cabin, running the point. Piedmont in the zone. Cabin tries to get it inside. They kick it back out to Kevin Evans, and he about drained another three. Ball rolled around and fell out. Piedmont with a basketball. Key with it. Right side. Little plate. Mike Key came around. Impact pass came from Milton on the inside, and Key kind of wheeled it and got fouled on his way up. And he scores, and the basket counts. He knocks down the free throw. Looked like Tanner Poole was hobbling a little bit as he came off of that free throw, but he seems to have walked it off. And he's ready to go. Columbia now with a basketball. Cabin about loses it. Taylor all over. Quay Wilson gets it over to Cabin and lets it go. Nice little shot. He drains a three. Just like that, the game is tied. Devontae Huntley into the game now for Piedmont. Excuse me. That's Kalen Bird into the game for Piedmont. Key. Loses one out, almost out of bounds, puts it up to Tanner Poole, and the ball spins around and falls. Columbia with a miss, Key with a rebound, nice pass into Malik Milton, and he takes it to the hole and gets fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Malik Milton is Piedmont's leading scorer in the first semester. Milton averaged a little over 16 points a game. And he drops the first free throw. Milton's a kid with a lot of potential and a lot of athletic ability. If he keeps it up, Milton could have his name in the rafters. He drops both of them, 31-27. Columbia with a basketball. Piedmont back into man. Cabin tries to drive, dishes it off to Ryan Faber, and Faber knocks it down. Piedmont having a little trouble in the post again tonight. And once again, Piedmont offense, they seem to be patient, but the ball just seems to be moving slow. kicks it out to Tanner Poole, who misses a little 15-footer. Minute 30 remaining here in the first half. Cabin, pull up, off the glass, misses it. Stuart Taylor has the ball, and he'll bring it down. Key drives the lane and scores. Piedmont up by four. Just over a minute remaining to go in the first half. Playing big number 44, tough on the post, and he keeps him out of there. Mike Key with a rebound. Here he comes, Key. Nice little pass to Stuart Taylor. He puts it up and in. And there's a timeout by Columbia International. And that's what you're going to get with Mike Key. He can rebound it, he can shoot it, and he can pass it. And Mike Key's just an all-around good player. MVP of the Piedmont Classic Tournament. And I believe all-conference last year. And he's a good addition to the team. Point 6 seconds remaining to go in the first half. Piedmont up by six. And Columbia International giving Piedmont all they want. And Columbia's win came against Kentucky Christian back in November. And Kentucky Christian was one of the teams that was in the tournament here last weekend that Piedmont beat. There's a kick out to J.C. Cavan, and he knocks down a three. There was a breakdown of communication on defense somewhere on that. And out of the timeout, that's something to be looking for, is that three-pointer. But Key with a basketball, 9 seconds remaining. Now Milton with it, up top. Driving the hole, goes all the way down. And there's a charge by Milton. .8 seconds left. Piedmont up by three. There's the inbounds pass. You don't want a foul here. And that'll do it for the first half. 35-32, Piedmont goes into the break for the three-point lead. We'll see you in a little while. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin the second half of tonight's game between Piedmont and Columbia. Piedmont's leading scorers was Mike Key with 12, and Malik Milton was right behind him with 11. And for Columbia, J.C. Cavan had 7, and Daniel Collins had 7. So Columbia starts the game out with a turnover. It'll be Piedmont's basketball. Piedmont starts out the game with Tyson. And there's just a pass that Piedmont did not need. Our interior passing has not been very good as of late. Columbia with a basketball. Columbia has been working the basketball and the shot clock down to below 10 most of the time tonight. And on that particular time, there was a foul on offense, and Piedmont will have the basketball. Now let's see what Coach Walker and the boys worked on during halftime. Tyson wide open from about 23 feet, and he knocks it down. And if you leave him open from that distance, he's going to have a lot of stats racked up for tonight. 38-32, Piedmont with a lead. There's a fight for the rebound. Looks like it was out on Nate Hewitt. According to Jeff Dre, anyway. Columbia inbounds the ball under their own goal. And Linus Unanis into the game for Piedmont. He's from Lithuania. For Columbia. He takes it all the way to the hole and misses. And I guess the call was off Javon Summers. It'll be Columbia's basketball. Columbia with a miss, and Milton and Key fight for the rebound. And I'm glad they didn't get a walk called on them. Piedmont running their offense. Tyson tried to come around a pick and use a little too much of his hands, and he got called for it. 38-32, Piedmont with the lead. Columbia with the basketball. And Unanis brings the ball down for Columbia. And there's a miscommunication. Ball goes out of bounds, and it'll go to Piedmont. Piedmont works the basketball around. Nice little pass from Summers to Milton to Key. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. It'll be Piedmont's basketball. 16 on the shot clock. Key will inbounds it to Tyson. Tyson out to Summers. 10 on the shot clock. Key inside to Hewitt, turn around her, misses it. A couple Piedmont guys came in to get the rebound and just kind of overplayed it. Columbia gets the ball. Columbia, nothing real complicated with their offense. They just set some screens and pick and rolls, and they're getting the open shots, and they're getting the boards. And ball went out on Piedmont, so it'll be Columbia's basketball. A little bit of words going on between Tyson and Unanis. And Tyson will take a seat for a little while, and Justin Valentine will come in the game. And there's a steal by Javon Summers, who takes it a nice, beautiful pass to Milton, and Milton throws it down. 40-32, Piedmont with a lead. Key, nice little box out for the rebound. He gets the basketball, crosses midcourt, kicks it to Milton. Milton kicks it back out. Javon Summers, good pass inside to Hewitt. Beautiful little pass to Hewitt. And there's a whistle. And I think referee Robbie Lester, if I can get my words right, referee Robbie Lester instructed a couple of the players to keep their mouths down just a little bit. Unanis will bring it down for Columbia. And Kevin Evans lowered his shoulder into Mike Key and tried to drive the lane. And there's an offensive foul call. Piedmont starting to build their lead. Let's see if they can extend it on out from here. Piedmont moving the ball around just a little bit quicker this half, and Key gets a shot block. Which is something you don't see very often. But the offense is looking a little better in the second half. They're being patient with it, but they're also moving the ball around a lot faster. Seemed in the first half we were trying to be patient with it, but it was a lot of dribbling and a lot of holding and not really moving the basketball around and making the defense work. And there's a block by Mike Key, and it went off Columbia's player, and it'll be Piedmont's basketball. And Roba Flynn into the game now for Piedmont. Piedmont with a 10-point lead. Now Piedmont's moving the ball around like a good team ought to. And there's what happens as a result. Nice passing, nice movement, and Key gets a baseline shot, and he scores. Key has 14. Marcus Prelo with a nice little turnaround over Milton. Not much you can do about that. Let's see if Piedmont continues to execute on offense. Swinging the ball well. Milton holding on to it. Now drives the lane out to Flint. Flint moves it out to Valentine. Valentine holding it a little long. 9 on the shot clock. Milton with it. Calls a play up top. Takes it to the lane. Misses. Hewitt there with a rebound. Follows up and he misses. And Columbia gets the ball down court. Unanis with a three, misses it, but Columbia with a rebound. Key went for it. Cavan with a nice little spin move, and he scores. Stewart Deese into the game for Columbia. Pass tried to force into Flint and out of bounds, but it'll be Piedmont's basketball. Key will take it out underneath the Piedmont's own goal.
Valentine holding on to the ball.
Offense, Piedmont's offense works best when Piedmont is passing and moving the basketball quickly. And they work the shot clock down. They're being patient that way. But they're not getting the shots they want. Or at least that time down court. And Piedmont's a young team with Mike Key back in the lineup. Sometimes gets a little bit of time. You need a little time to work on your chemistry and work on how each other plays. And Unanis drives the lane and Tanner Poole trying to block it. There's a foul called on him. Well, right when you thought Piedmont may put it away, Columbia has climbed right back into it, 44-38. And Unanis will go to the line to shoot one. Five-point ball game, 13-42 remaining. Stuart Taylor now with the basketball. Taylor and Roba Flint, Mike Key, Malik Milton, and Tanner Poole into the game for Piedmont. Little pull-up jumper by Milton. Milton's got a pretty little jumper on him. And he utilized it that time, and Piedmont up by seven. Roba Flint called for the foul. And Columbia will take it out on the sideline. Unanis with it. Puts up a little left-handed scoop. He misses it. Taylor with a rebound. Taylor gets it up the court quickly. Piedmont looks for transition, didn't get it, and kicked it out and set up the offense. That's a good look for Piedmont that time down court on transition. Taylor had Poole open, tried to get it to him. The ball was tipped, and Poole tried to get it, and it came off of his hand, and now it'll be Columbia's basketball again. 7-point lead. Columbia working around. Nice little offensive possession. Piedmont up by five now. Milton in the pull. Bad interior pass. Stewart Deese tries to take it to the hole, and Malik Milton sets up for a charge, and he took it. And it'll be Piedmont's basketball. Tanner Poole's closeout defense was just a little too slow, and by the time he got there, Deese was already heading to the lane. But Milton took the charge and bailed his teammate out on that one. .44 remaining in the second half. Piedmont came out and had several good possessions of offense down the court and started pulling away. And then they had several bad ones in a row, and just like that, Columbia's back in the game. When Piedmont sets up, runs their offense, executes it well, then Piedmont
is a really good basketball team, and there will be hardly anybody in this district that's going to compete with them. If we can get that down for 40 straight minutes of basketball, Piedmont's going to be tough to deal with down the stretch. C.J. Tyson is now checked back into the game for Piedmont. Key holding on the basketball. Now he dribbles to the top. Key misses a three. Columbia now with a basketball. 11 minutes remaining. Piedmont up by five. Key with a steal. Marcus Prelo was looking inside and Key knew he was going to pass it in there and just took it away from him. And on the other end, Tyson drills one from about 25 feet. Yunanis tries to take it in and misses. Tanner Poole with a rebound. Here comes Tyson with the basketball. Pulls it out to Flint. Flint for three. He misses it. Be a turnover on Columbia. Daniel Collins faked a three and took an extra step before his dribble went down, and Piedmont is now up by eight. Javon Summers is checked back into the game, and he came in for Roba Flint. And Summers with a beautiful pass into Key, who just missed it. Tyson pulls up for three, and Piedmont's going to have to learn how to follow their shot. That should be Piedmont's basketball. It was off on Yunanis. That's about six shots I've seen tonight from Piedmont where they let it go and were heading down court, and the ball hit the rim and bounced right back to where they were at. Forty-nine, 41, Piedmont by eight. Javon Summers with the ball at the top. Takes it all the way to the hole. And just couldn't finish it. And Columbia gets it down quickly the other end, and there's a foul on Michael Key. And J.C. Cabin will go to the line to shoot two. Cabin makes the first one. When I was talking with Coach Mendenhall earlier today, he said that Cabin has been his most consistent player all year. And Cabin tonight is showing that. He's been consistent all night and has ran the offense well. Has hardly turned the basketball over and played pretty good defense. Tyson with another miss. Columbia quickly down court. The ball goes up three or four times and there's a battle for it, and finally there's a jump ball. And it'll go Piedmont's way. And Nathan Hewitt will come in the game for Tanner Poole.
Coach Mendenhall and referee Robbie Lester talking some things over. Not for sure what they're talking about, but conversation seems to be over. And we'll resume the game. Javon Summers back into the game for Piedmont. Now Piedmont's moving the ball. Inside pass to Hewitt. One pass too many, and Hewitt should have been looking to shoot the shot. And instead, he was looking to pass. And now Columbia just scored, and they're within four. Piedmont now with some good movement on offense. Shot clock down to 10. Good in pass to Hewitt. And once again, Hewitt should have taken that shot up. He was wide open and just looked to pass it. And that's what I mean when Piedmont runs their offense and executes it and quickly moves the ball around. They've got enough weapons to score from any position on the court. And they had a great interior pass from Stuart Taylor that time, and Hewitt didn't even look to score. I'm not for sure why, because Hewitt's pretty dominant inside. And when he's that open, usually he'll tear that goal off. Columbia within one. Piedmont can't seem to put it away. We're heading down the stretch of the ball game, and this is where your senior leadership, this is where your upperclassmen on your basketball team has got to show the correct leadership on the court and carry you to the finish line. So I would be looking for Mike Key and Javon Summers to have a lot of the ball handling time when it comes for the rest of the game. And Summers with the ball, the senior guard right out of here of Winston-Salem, North Carolina, played one of the best games I've seen him play the other night against Kentucky Christian. And him and Mike Key really played well together. Milton with a miss, but Hewitt got a piece of it, knocked it out to Milton, knocked it out to Key, and Key grabbed it, and it's a new shot clock for Piedmont. And Milton with a nice pass out to Key, and Key should have followed a shot on that one and didn't. Columbia with a basketball. Kevin Evans was just hopping up and down asking for the basketball, and he got it and let it go, and he missed it, but Ryan Faber got the rebound and bailed him out. And Unanez just lowered his shoulder and went to the goal, and he scored. Columbia with a one-point lead. Key to Tyson, who gets the shooter's touch from three, and he scores. And
once again, Unanez just kind of lowers his head, lowers his shoulder, and dribbles around until he gets a shot and fires it up, and it went in. Ball game tied at 52. Summers. Into Hewitt. Hewitt loses it. There's a fight for it. It's out on Columbia. And it'll be Piedmont's basketball with six on the shot clock. Key pulls up, lets it go, knocks it down, and ball bounces long again. Here comes Unanez, lowers his shoulder. It'll be jump basketball. Possession arrow, Columbia. Kevin Evans just bulldogs his way to the hole and he scores. Piedmont down by two. Milton in the corner for three. And there's a whistle. Randy Doolin blows the whistle and I think that'll be on number one, Daniel Collins. Milton for three, misses it. Nobody went for the boards for Piedmont. Stood around and watched it. And I'm sure Coach Walker's not happy about that one. 54-52. Seven on the shot clock, and there's a steal by Tyson. And he and Tyson got fouled on that one. And Tyson got away with one right there, and what I mean by that is anytime you're throwing the ball out of bounds, saving it under the other team's basketball goal, especially when there's more numbers with the other team, throw the ball long on your end of the court. And luckily that time, Piedmont got away with one. And now the basketball, 54-52, game getting into crunch time. Just a little over 4 minutes left to go. If I was Piedmont, I'd be looking for Mike Key. Milton takes one to the hole and misses. And number 44, Ryan Faber, sets a moving pick. And Piedmont will have the basketball. .342 remaining. Columbia in a zone. Malik Milton pulls up from the top and drains it. Piedmont up by one. That's one way to bust open a zone, and Unanez takes it to the head down and takes it all the way, and Michael Key throws it up and scores. And Daniel Collins is called for the foul.
Nunez lowered his head again and took off to the goal. He missed it, and the rebound was kicked out to Key, and Key took it the length of the court. And Daniel Collins was all over him, and somehow Key made that shot. 57-54, Piedmont up by three. Nunez dribbling the air out of the basketball. And Tyson's called for the foul. And Stuart Taylor will come in for Tyson. .251 remaining. Nunez with a basketball, lowers his head. And Collins with a miss down low, and Piedmont with a rebound. Three-point lead, 2:25 remaining. And Javon Summers brings it out. And Coach Walker is going to call a 30-second timeout to talk about it. Both teams in the 1-1. Calling a play for probably either Milton or Key for a three-pointer, and if not, a dump inside to Hewitt, and then on defense. He's just going to say play good straight-up defense and be sure you box out. A nice play designed for an inlet to Hewitt, and he dropped it off the Key, and Columbia just played good defense on it. Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet. No fouls to bail them out right here. And Kevin Evans just once again bulldogs his way to the hole, and he scores. Evans kind of reminds me of a Charles Barkley, the way he plays. Piedmont up by one. 1:28 remaining. Milton spins it and loses it. And Evans comes up with it. And Evans comes down all the way and blocked by Hewitt. And Evans will go to the line to shoot two. He misses the first one. Evans misses the second one. Hewitt with a rebound. This is where you want to play smart basketball. This is where you want to understand the situation. Know what the score is. Know how much time is remaining. What you don't want to do is if you miss, then try to go for the ball if Columbia gets the rebound and make a stupid foul. And Coach Walker will call a timeout and talk it over. Once again, 13 on the shot clock. Not a lot remaining
far as free throw percentages, if you want to look and see at the foul line, Mike Key is an 88% free throw shooter. Malik Milton, 76%. C.J. Tyson is 86%. Trying to see who will be out on the floor. Nathan Hewitt and Javon Summers are a little over 50% at the line. So if you're going to look to foul somebody, Key for three. He doesn't get it, but Hewitt with a rebound. And I'm not for sure who that pass was going to, but Piedmont came up with it. Columbia in their zone. Not coming out of it. They're going to make Piedmont take it down and take the shot clock down. And once again, Piedmont calls a timeout with 13 seconds on the shot clock. Key got a wide open look. Well, out of the last timeout, he just didn't make it. And Hewitt came up with a huge rebound. And so with 26.6 seconds remaining, Piedmont's up by one. And if I was a betting man, I'd put my money that Mike Key's going to be the man to touch it again. And once again, your strategy here is if you score, if you hit a three, you go up by two possessions. And even if you just hit a two, your strategy is going to be make sure you don't foul on this end of the court. And you don't want to foul at all. But you don't want an over-the-back call. You don't want something like that, especially if they foul you. And there's Tyson wide open, and he drains it. There's a good call by Coach Walker out of a timeout. Now, here's where you've got to know the situation. 13 seconds left to go in the game. Piedmont's up by four. And Coach Walker is just basically going to tell these boys to play good defense and not to foul. And you especially don't want to foul if they're pulling up to shoot a three. Columbia will inbound it near their bench, near the hash mark. They can't get the ball inbounds, and they have to call another timeout. Well, if you're Kyle Mendenhall for Columbia, I'm trying to think of what you might do in this situation since he's taking the basketball outside at the hash mark. I think I would try to run some type of pick to come up underneath to where you hit someone at the baseline, or you got hit the guy taking the ball back out of bounds for a quick three. And there he's going to give it to Evan. Scores underneath with 5 seconds left, and another timeout's called. Now, if I'm Walker, Coach Walker, I'm putting in my best ball handlers and best free throw shooters, because Columbia is going to have to foul immediately. 5 seconds left. Maybe take a second, maybe two, to go for the steal. And if you don't get it, then foul. But I would probably try to foul right on the inbounds pass. And if I was Coach Mendenhall, I would do my best to keep Michael Key from getting the ball. Not only is Mike Key a senior, he also is a 88% free throw shooter. With the players Piedmont has on the floor, Mendenhall doesn't have a whole lot of a choice to. Of personnel to foul. And I believe that's Piedmont's last time out. And you might say, hey, why is it that it towards the end of the games like this, that it's harder for a team to inbounds the ball, and why is there a lot more timeouts called? And it's not necessarily that they can't get the ball inbounds. You just don't want to take a chance of not getting it in and ball getting bounced around and somehow Columbia coming up with a shot and making it towards the end of the to win the game. In those situations, you're taught if there's any chance that you might not be able to get it in, you call a timeout. And that's what was done right there. Now, like I said, I believe that was Coach Walker and Piedmont's last timeout. So the ball's got to be inbounds this time, and they get the ball to Key, and that's the guy that I would have covered up the most. 3.9 seconds. Key makes both of them. Ball game's over. It will be a 1-1. And in this situation, you don't want to foul at all, and Coach Walker gets Valentine and Milton out of the lane just in case, or just to make sure that chance is taken away. Key makes the first one. It's a 3-point ball game. And I'm not sure why his players are hovering right behind him. And I don't know why they're playing defense that deep. Just let them score. And that's ball game. 62-58. Piedmont comes away with a win. And at times it wasn't pretty, but we're glad to have it. We'll see you next time.